Henry, that way that you were looking there was very good. Hold tight. Excellent. Okay, and I'm going back. Okay, I think that's a very good start.
Straight to the camera over here. Not sure yet. Take it out altogether, please.
Let's drop this hand down. So bring your hand. That's it. So you're almost, yeah. So you're almost adjusting it more than pulling it tight.
Good. It's nice.
It's quite interesting. What I was picking up immediately was that Henry was always trying to find context, his context, where he fits, how he settled in his life. That sense of home was what pervaded the narrative for the image that I wanted to create for Henry.
That was the house. That was my foster parents' house. That one there. Well, next door, that one, was their son.
His kind of childhood terrain has always been different to his adult terrain that he lives in with Yvonne.
And that's when we got put into what we call proper clothes. We had proper jackets and tie and shirts and things.
Keep looking there, that's so good.
I think I was 13 years old when that one was taken.
I photographed him in his studio and I had lunch with him. I have a long story
about
names dropping.
Right, come on.
I'm also like to know that you're portrait's going to be here permanently.
I'm really very honoured. I also actually think this is really not about me. I think this is about the thousands of children that were brought up in the Foundling Hospital and from the very word go were considered to be second-class citizens.
And it's exactly kind of how I've always made my work. Even though I make individual portraits, you become a voice for a certain experience.
It's a representation of, in this case, yeah. 24,000 plus children who were brought up within the Foundling Hospital. And then being brought up with this very strict discipline, where certainly when you left school, you knew the difference between right and wrong. And if you went wrong, you expected to pay for it.
You know, it's a very similar experience. You know, my father was really tough and very disciplined on us, and you know, my parents had a very tricky marriage, so there was a lot of violence and control.
One of the wonderful things about the Foundling Hospital was that we were all the boys were given the opportunity to learn to play musical instruments, and all through my life I have found that as an escape mechanism, sitting in bands and orchestras. I'm just wondering whether there was any escape mechanism for you in going into what you did.
Totally. You had such difficult upbringing. You're constantly questioning who you are, and so my work is all about self-discovery. You know, and all the work that I make looks at identity politics. It talks about, you know, who we are as individuals. What does it mean to be in a society that actively tells you don't belong?
One of the things I've always looked in life is to try and be accepted for who I am and not where I came from and how I got there.
So what I wanted to do with your portrait was to really talk about that idea of mirroring theory, the fact that because you didn't have parents growing up, they didn't, you know, reaffirm who you were.
There are very few people who were brought up in the way I was that don't ask that same question, and hence we go off to try and find out who our fathers were, who our mother was, to get some sense of exactly where we came from and who we are.
It's been such a pleasure to meet you, John, and I feel like we've got such a connection.
I've really enjoyed the experience, and it's nice to talk to somebody else who has had a different, completely different life to me, with different issues and difficulties. And there's a comparison running through the whole thing as to how we deal with it.
Nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you.
Yeah, yes. You're looking great. You've had your hair done, I know. You
I
told
did,
me that,
I had it
yeah.
done specially.
Yeah, yeah. Fantastic. And this is great.
I thought you'd like this.
Yeah.
And if you saw me outside, David, you would have seen these.
Oh, you can't wear those. That'd be too much.
You would have seen them outside, David. The girls like them. You're just jealous, David.
So I started with this one, because this is the easy one, Lydia.
Mm-hmm.
The easy one to achieve. I think the other one's going to be a little bit more complicated.
Okay.
Lydia, I want you to go on this. Just blow your cheeks out a bit. Yeah, do it again. That's good. Okay. And just jog your chin down a little bit. Just look, that's good. That's great. These portraits on the staircase at Foundlings are quite intense, aren't they?
Yes.
They really are. Okay, Tarang, get up high. Let's just get up high and go back. Come
closer, Tarang. I am a mother. It has made me realise that love is a very important thing in a child's life. If I'd met her when I was growing up, I would have said, what the heck did you give up your baby for? I would have been very angry, very upset.
Okay, let's just go to the back again.
But I moved through that.
Up the stairs where we're
and as an adult, understanding the ways of the world, not knowing that when I was born it was the biggest sin to have a child out of wedlock, and how she would have suffered, then I understand things more.
Okay, straight at the camera.
I don't have too many memories of this room, because again, as I say, we were only five, and there are photographs of us in here, I think, as well, somewhere. For some reason, I feel very proud of this room, because I feel in the harsh reality of our life up here, this just seemed to me that whoever designed this classroom had a bit of a soft spot, you know, was thinking they were for young children. I think it's very nice. Mm. They say the camera doesn't lie, it does lie, it's making me look better than I am.
Camera lies every time.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. Every photograph is alright. There'll be quite subtle things that will make it an image that goes forward or an image that doesn't.
She looks like a very contented lady, doesn't she?
I think that too.
Yes. Mm.